What's up, everybody? I am Jaspreet Singh, and welcome to The Minority Mindset. I talk a lot about becoming an entrepreneur and an investor because, well, I am an entrepreneur and an investor, so I've seen what's possible when you think different and create your own path. But I am also an attorney. I went to law school and did really well, and I passed the bar exam, so I can scare people by telling them that I'm an attorney. So I see you're trying to screw me over. Let me just remind you that I'm a lawyer. Now, although I am an attorney, I don't work as a lawyer. I am a full-time entrepreneur and an investor, although I am thinking about creating a business and legal consulting firm where we would help you with business matters. And if you have legal matters, we would be able to help you with that too, because most lawyers don't have a clue of how digital businesses work. So I would partner with and train attorneys to understand digital entrepreneurship so we could provide you with that. But this is just something I'm thinking about right now. And because I am both an entrepreneur and an attorney, I can talk about both, which is why today I want to talk about what's harder, becoming a successful lawyer or becoming a successful entrepreneur. But before we begin, make sure you hit that thumbs up button just below the screen. Let's talk about becoming a lawyer first. If you want to become a lawyer, the path is relatively straightforward. First, you have to do good in college and take the LSAT exam, and then you get into and go to law school. And after going to law school for a number of years, you have to take the brutal 2-day bar exam, which is no joke. For most people, it will take you 3 years to finish up law school, but for me, it took me 4 because I spent the last year and a half or so of law school part-time since I was working on a number of different businesses while going to school, one of which is Minority Mindset. Just admit it, Jaspreet, you're slow. And if you want to be a high-paid attorney, there is a plan for that. You have to bust your butt in school, and then you have to get a good internship, and then you can go work at a big law firm and bring in the big bucks, making over 6 figures a year out of law school. Now, while the path is relatively straightforward, doing it is not very easy because, well, becoming a lawyer is not easy. You're gonna be reading a ton of law books that are thousands of pages long, which have 8-point font that look like this. And then you have to do your reading, because if you don't, then your professor is gonna make you look stupid in front of the entire class. And lucky for me, looking stupid doesn't really bother me too much. Okay, so if you wanna be a big shot attorney, you gotta go to law school. And if you go to a good law school, that's even better. You have to bust your butt and then get a job at a big law firm, and you're on track and on pace to become a big shot attorney. You have to bust your butt to do it, but that's how you do it. Becoming a successful entrepreneur is a little bit different. And for the sake of this video, I'm gonna be talking about how to build a YouTube channel to keep things simple, because building a YouTube channel is building a business. If you wanted to build a successful YouTube channel, what would you do?
I don't know. I don't think my school has a YouTube major.
See, there's no step-by-step plan on how to build a successful YouTube channel or how to be a successful entrepreneur. Trust me, I've looked. I mean, you can study the top YouTubers and you can apply what they did, but there's no guarantee that if you follow this plan and you work really hard, you will build a successful YouTube channel. It doesn't work like that. First, you gotta figure out what you wanna make videos on. And then you gotta figure out how you wanna speak on camera. And then you gotta figure out how you want your videos to look. And then you gotta figure out how you're gonna market your videos. And then you gotta figure out how you're gonna engage with your audience. And then you gotta figure out how you're gonna make money. Like, there's no set path on how you can do any one of these things, and you gotta figure out your way of doing each one of them. Like, there's no plan, no formula, no license, no test, no internship, and no curriculum that guarantees if you follow this plan step by step and you work your butt, you are guaranteed to have a successful YouTube channel. Everything is just one big question mark. Yeah, you can read books and you can study other successful YouTubers and you can take courses on it, but you have to be the one to figure out how to apply all of this to you, because your slate, your page, your book is all blank and you have to write it yourself. I had to study a lot to figure out how to grow our channel. But it wasn't your traditional just reading a textbook studying. No, I was actually out there looking at successful YouTubers and seeing what they did and why they did it and wondering why they did certain things, and then strategically applying things that they did to our channel with my own flavor. If you go and become an attorney, you know that after 3 years of law school, you're gonna start making the lawyer checks. But as an entrepreneur or as a YouTuber,
there's no clue on how long it will take for you to start making money. Like on our YouTube channel, it took us a year and some months to get our first YouTube ad revenue check of like 2400 or 2500 bucks. If I worked for a year and a half as a business attorney, charging clients $300 an hour for work, I would have made a whole lot more money over that time. But the advantage of me being an entrepreneur and an investor is that I've had the opportunity to build different income streams, which is why it's not worth my time to go and physically work as a lawyer. It took us 2 years for our channel to finally take off with consistent work every single week. There's no defined path or timeline of how long it will take for your business or your YouTube channel to take off. And when you're trying to figure out what's happening and what you should be doing as an entrepreneur or as a YouTuber, there's no book or place you can go to give you all this information. Like, you can subscribe to newsletters and take courses and study these things, but you just gotta figure it out. If I wanna know what's happening with tax law, then I can study cases that went to the court and I can see what the IRS is saying. It's still a gray area, but at least I can get an idea based on these things. So when it comes to actually becoming successful, being an entrepreneur is much harder because everything is a big question mark. There's no plan, no curriculum, nothing. You have to start with a blank slate and figure it out as you go. And if your plan doesn't work out, you have to start all over again, and it can take you a whole lot longer than 3 years. But let me also say this, if your goal is to become a super successful attorney, then it's a little bit different because now you have to be an entrepreneur and an attorney because you have to figure out how to be different than all the other attorneys and make yourself stick out. As for the physical work required to become a successful attorney or becoming a successful entrepreneur, this one really depends. It can go either way. It depends on you. I work a lot of hours because I enjoy what I do. If I worked as a lawyer, I'm sure I'd be working just as hard because that's who I am. You can get by as an attorney or as an entrepreneur by not working that hard, and you could also be a very hardworking attorney and a very hardworking entrepreneur. This depends on you, and you know, the results that you get is gonna be correlated to the amount of effort that you put in. And that's why it pays to work hard while working smart and working in the right direction. Thank you for watching. If you enjoyed our video, hit that thumbs up button and share it with one friend so we can help spread the word. Don't miss our new videos on entrepreneurship, business, and money every Monday, Wednesday, and Friday at 7:30 a.m. Eastern Standard Time. So hit the subscribe button and the notification bell below. That way you actually find out when our new videos are released. And as always, keep hustling.